So topic is free space propagation model. First thing is coming over here, free space. Okay, so free space का मतलब क्या हो गया? There is no obstacle between the transmitter and receiver. Okay, तभी एक हमारे पास line of sight available होती है. ठीक है, I think ये आप सभी को पता होगा. Okay, so एग्जाम्पल के तौर पे अगर मैं बोलूं कि जहाँ पे लाइन ऑफ साइट अवेलेबल रहती है, ओके, मींस देयर इज नो ऑब्स्टिकल बिटवीन द ट्रांसमीटर एंड रिसीवर. सो एग्जाम्पल विल बी योर सैटेलाइट कम्युनिकेशन. ओके, जहाँ पे हम बात करें कि जो हमारे टावर्स रहते हैं, आपने देखा होगा जो डिश टीवीज होते हैं, एंटीना, वो डायरेक्टली कनेक्टेड हमारे क्या होते हैं, सैटेलाइट्स होते हैं उनके बीच में. So 90% cases ऐसे होते हैं, there is no obstacle between the transmitter and receiver. Okay, so free space मतलब आपका उन दोनों के बीच में कोई भी obstacle नहीं, there is always line of sight available. Okay, so now the next thing is propagation model हम क्यों use कर रहे हैं, हमारा motive क्या है, why we are doing these calculations. ओके, सो मॉडल्स हम इसलिए कैलकुलेट कर रहे हैं, क्यों बना रहे हैं, क्योंकि हमें जो कैलकुलेशन करनी है वो करनी है पाथ लॉस की, कि जब हम ट्रांसमीटर से रिसीवर पे सेंड कर रहे हैं तो कितने लॉसेस हो रहे हैं हमारे सिग्नल में. ओके, सो जस्ट राइटिंग, इफ आई टॉक अबाउट दी free space propagation model, model is used to predict received signal strength when the transmitter and receiver have a clear unobstructed line of sight path between them. Okay, so you can see over here why we are using to predict the received signal strength, ki jo receiver pe hamare paas signal receive ho raha hai uski strength kitni hai. Okay, or in other words we can say ki losses kitne hue aapke, usko hum calculate karte hain. Okay, now example, as I already told you, satellite communication, system and your microwave line of sight, radio links, typically undergo free space propagation. Okay, so वो communication obviously free space की बात कर रहे हैं, means there will be no obstacle between the transmitter and receiver. So इस तरह के जितने भी हमारे communication system होंगे वो हमारे किसके through होंगे, free space propagation model के through. Now important point is as with most large scale radio wave propagation, models the free space model predict that received power decays as a function of the TR separation distance raised to some power. Okay, because I think this formula is known to you. This is PT, GT, GR, lambda square upon 4 pi ka whole square D square R. Okay. So, for receiving the power, okay, receive power that is calculated by the PT, GT, GR, lambda square upon 4 pi square D square L. Okay, where if I talk about this, PT is, if I talk about this, PT is your transmitted power, PR is your received power, GT is transmitter antenna gain. GR is your received receiver antenna gain. And obviously your L is, okay, 4 pi square. D is the separation between the transmitter and receiver. L is the system loss. Okay. And lambda is the wavelength. Okay. So these are the your term are using to calculate the receive power. Okay, and this L, if I talk about this L, in most cases this L is greater than equal to 1. Okay, so if L equal to 1, whenever if the L is equal to 1 is given, okay, so it means no loss, वहाँ पे कोई भी loss नहीं हो रहा है. और अगर ये बड़ा है 1 से, तो obviously it is understood कि वहाँ पे कुछ losses हो रहे हैं. Okay, now this GT and GR, okay, gain of the antenna. Is calculated by G equal to 4 pi A upon lambda square. Okay, where if I talk about this, A is known as effective aperture, this effective aperture is related with this, the size of the antenna, physical size of the antenna, and lambda, all of you know. And if I talk about this lambda, so this lambda equal to C by F or 2 pi C upon omega C, where this C is your speed of the light. And this omega C is carrier frequency in radian per second. Okay. So these are the terms. Now, if I talk about this isotropic antenna, there are some another important formula. Okay. This EIRP is known as effective isotropic radiated power, known as EIRP. Okay. This EIRP is given by PT GT. Okay. Now, important ये है कि maybe in exam they will ask some numerical problem based on these formulas. Okay. So, in dV, if you want to calculate the your path loss in dV, so that is given by path loss in dB 10 log PT upon PR. Okay, so that is the path loss in dB. PT is transmitted power, PR is your received power. Now, if I talk about this formula, you already know this PR related to its PT. Okay, so from here you can easily calculate the, so it will come minus 10 log. I'm directly writing the result, GT GR lambda square upon 4 pi whole square D square. And if you are considering this in the same formula, if you are considering this, your antennas are having unity gain. If you are considering, yahan main likh deta hu, considering unity gain and path loss. So if these two term is given, if we are taking the unity, okay? So if you're taking path loss equal to 1, it is understood ki वहाँ पे कोई भी सिस्टम में लॉस नहीं है. सो जो आपका ये इक्वेशन थी वो रिड्यूस होके क्या हो जाएगी, डायरेक्टली यू कैन राइट इट डाउन, पी एल इन डी वी इक्वल टू माइनस टेन लॉग, बिकॉज दिस जी टी जी आर इक्वल टू क्या हो गया, वन हो गया. सो डायरेक्टली लैम्डा स्क्वायर अपॉन फोर पाई स्क्वायर डी स्क्वायर. ओके, नाउ ये तो हो गया कैलकुलेशन पार्ट, फॉर्मूलास फॉर कैलकुलेटिंग दी सिंपल रिसीव पावर, उसके बाद पाथ लॉस कैसे कैलकुलेट होगा. नाउ देयर इज वन इम्पोर्टेंट पैरामीटर इज दैट इज योर, लेट्स सी, दिस इज इक्वेशन वन, दिस इज इक्वेशन नंबर वन, दिस इज इक्वेशन नंबर टू, this is equation number 3, this is equation number 4, and this is equation number 5. Okay, so let's see. Now if we see the equation number 1, this equation PR equal to PT GT GR upon lambda square into lambda square upon 4 pi square D square L, this equation is called the Friis-Free space equation or Friis-Free space model. So Friis-Free space model is only a valid predictor for PR for values of the which are in the far field of the transmitting antenna. Okay, so here one term is coming, that is your far field. Okay, now this far field, if I talk about this far field, or is also known as Fraunhofer region. So this far field or Fraunhofer region of a transmitting antenna is defined as the region beyond the far field distance DF, which is related the largest dimension of the transmitter antenna aperture and the carrier wavelength. So if I talk about this from far field, okay, so far field means ek tarah se ye ho gaya ki ek antenna hai, us antenna se wo antenna एक पर्टिकुलर डिस्टेंस तक ही अपना कम्युनिकेशन प्रोवाइड करा सकता है या उसको एक चैनल प्रोवाइड करा सकता है. तो वो लॉन्गेस्ट डिस्टेंस, ओके, वो एक तरह से अगर आपका BTS है और एक मोबाइल यूज़र है, वो उस BTS से कितने दूर तक जा सकता है ताकि वो BTS उसको चैनल असाइनमेंट कर सके. ओके, सो वो हमारी फॉर फील्ड रीजन होती है. दिस फॉर फील्ड ऑफ फ्राउनहोफर रीजन, this d is this Fraunhofer distance df is calculated by 2 d square upon lambda, where d is the obviously largest physical linear dimension of the antenna. Okay, now so this is all the your formulas. And the last one, if you want to write it down, you can also write it down, this formula in dBm. Okay, this formula calculation dBm, that is tan log PR D naught upon 0.001 W plus 20 log D naught by D. Okay, this is formula is D naught and DF. So this formula give you the received power strength in dBm when this Fraunhofer distance is given. Okay, ek reference distance se aapko, let's say this d naught is your reference distance, so us reference distance se kitni range par aap calculate karna chahte hain, so that can be calculated with this formula. Okay, so you can write it down, this equation number 7, this is equation number, let's see, 6. Okay, so this is all about your free space propagation model.